Hello children, we are discussing consumer's equilibrium, and in the previous lectures we have discussed that there are two approaches through which we can explain consumer's equilibrium, that is cardinal approach and ordinal approach. We also discussed that tool of cardinal approach is utility, and we had discussed that what is utility, what are different types of utility, and we discussed law of diminishing marginal utility also. Today in this lecture, we are going to discuss consumer's equilibrium in case of one commodity and in case of more than one commodity. So after going through this lecture, you will be able to learn consumer's equilibrium. You will be able to learn consumer's equilibrium, what cardinal approach. Okay, we will discuss this equilibrium, consumer's equilibrium, in case of single commodity or one commodity, and in case of more than one commodity. Okay, so after finishing this lecture, we will be able to understand consumer's equilibrium cardinal approach. As we know that this approach has been propounded by Marshall, and we will discuss in case of one commodity and more than one commodity. So let's begin. Students, when you go to market to buy something, you pay in terms of rupees, means purchase consideration. When you go to shop to purchase anything, there becomes an agreement between you and seller. You are buyer and shopkeeper is seller. So there becomes an agreement. And what is agreement? That shopkeeper will give product to you, goods to you, and you will pay price for that goods. Good. Okay. So here give and take is there. If shopkeeper gives goods only to you and you don't pay price, this is not purchase. And if you pay price and shopkeeper is not giving goods to you, this is not also a purchase. So for a contract to be valid contract, consideration has to be there. Consideration is must. Okay, so here in this contract, for a buyer, consideration is that the product he is getting, and the for seller, consideration is the price he is getting. Okay, so when you pay price for your product, okay, when you go to buy, suppose this chalk, I am going to market to buy this chalk, so I have to pay for this chalk. So this payment of price is, this payment of price is what? This payment of price is sacrifice by consumer. Sacrifice by consumer. Okay, and when you pay price, you receive receipt of goods is what? Is gain for consumer. Receipt for of good is gain for consumer. Okay, so for consumer to remain in equilibrium, this sacrifice should be equal to gain. Okay, if this sacrifice Stanford has is greater than gain, means you are paying according to you. Suppose I feel if the price of this stock is rupees 1 per piece and I pay rupees 2, I must get 2 chalk. Okay, what I am getting 1 chalk only. My sacrifice is rupees 1, my sacrifice is rupees 2. And my gain is 1 chalk only. My gain is 1 chalk only. It means what? It means my sacrifice is more than gain. Will I deal? I will not deal. Because my sacrifice is more than my gain. Here shopkeeper will be happy, but we will not accept the deal. Second case is if sacrifice is less than gain. Okay, your sacrifice is rupees 1 and your gain is 2 chalks. Your gain is 2 chalks. You will be happy. Again, here shopkeeper will not be ready, because what is happening that your gain is shopkeeper's sacrifice. My gain, if I go to shop to buy something, my gain is shopkeeper's sacrifice, and shopkeeper's sacrifice is my gain and my. Okay, so two parties are here, buyer and seller. Buyer's sacrifice is shopkeeper's gain, and shopkeeper's sacrifice is buyer's gain. Being the student of commerce, you must have read this in accounts. Okay. Credit and debit. Each credit is having a debit entry and each debit is having a credit entry. Okay, so what we see, this, if this is the situation, you will not deal. If this is the situation, shopkeeper will not deal. So when you deal, when this sacrifice is equal to gain, means you are sacrificing rupees 2 and you are getting 2 chalks. So when this is the situation, you are in a position and you will accept the deal. This is the case. Okay, it seems very simple that okay, I will be in equilibrium, consumer will be in equilibrium, because whatever he is sacrificing, he is gaining. But how will we know that I have reached to the situation? Okay. So, Marshall has explained at the commercial level, you will discuss it in detail, but at the plus 2 level, you have to discuss. Marshall explained that if consumer, while consuming a commodity, purchasing a commodity, attains a particular level, then he will be in equilibrium. And he said that, you know, that when you consume a commodity, then you get utility, and from additional commodity, whatever utility you get, that is known as marginal utility. Suppose the consumer is there and consumes commodity X. Consumer consumes commodity X. Then according to Marshall, in case of single commodity, in case of single commodity, consumer remains in equilibrium. Consumer remains in equilibrium when following condition is satisfied. When following condition is satisfied. What condition? What condition? That is MUX. Okay, when you consume a commodity, you will get utility from that. Okay, so MUX divided by PX. MUX divided by PX. If it is equal to MUM, then consumer will remain in equilibrium. This is the condition of consumer's equilibrium. Okay, here I told you, whenever you use a symbol, must abbreviate. Here what we see, here MUX is what? Marginal utility from commodity X. MUX is marginal utility from commodity X. PX is price of X. Okay. As you consume commodity, so from the additional unit whatever you get, that is known as marginal utility. Similarly, when you earn money or when you spend money, from additional money, the satisfaction, the utility you get, that is known as marginal utility of money. It differs. Suppose I have rupees 100 in my pocket, okay, and my friend asked, get two cold drinks for us, we will have it. Number one case. That case one, I have rupees 100 and my friend is requesting for two bottles of cold drink. Okay. Number two case, I am having rupees 1000 and my friend is requesting for two bottles of cold drink. Now, under which situation I will feel comfortable? In which case I will feel comfortable? Case 1 or case 2? Naturally, I will be comfortable in case 2, because there, suppose for 2 bottles of cold drink I have to spend rupees 100 and I have rupees 1000, still I will be left with 1000. So, if I am having rupees 1000, I will have less pain. I will feel less pain in spending rupees 100. But if I am having 100 rupees only and I have to spend rupees 100, so I will have more pain to spend rupees 100. Maybe I will not spend. Okay. What I am trying to convince to you that as in case of commodities, as more and more commodities we consume, utility from additional commodity declines. Same happens in case of money also. As more and more money we have, utility what we derive from additional money, that declines. So here MUM is marginal utility of money. MUM is marginal utility of money. So what is this MUX? What is this MUX? Means marginal utility of commodity X. That is the gain you get. That is your gain. And we have gain, we pay price for also. So gain in terms of what? Gain in terms of price. Okay, how much price we are paying? Okay, this is MUX. And this is our sacrifice. How much money in terms of marginal utility we sacrifice? So Marshall said that if this condition MUX by PX, if it is equal to MUM, then consumer will remain in equilibrium. Okay, let us explain with the help of an example. Children, this is very important because a straight question may come. A straight question may come in the board examination. Okay, and in examinations. Apart from that, numerical questions also can come from this topic. Okay, so Marshall said, I have condition here that when if commodity X is consumed, mu x is equal to divided mu x by px is equal to mu m, then consumer remains in equilibrium. This is our equilibrium condition. Now take an example. Okay, so you can take any example. You understand the topic, and as per your convenience, you can take example. No need to by heart. No need to the schedule which I am taking here. You too. As I have not taken, I have in my mind right now there is no topic schedule. Just I will plan and I will try to fit here. Okay, yes, one thing is important that whenever you take any example should be simplified one, simple one. It is not someone is taking very complex example which need complex calculations, and someone takes very easy example. It is not that examiner will give more marks to those who have taken complex example and less marks to those who have taken simple example, not at all. Purpose of example is that you are able to explain. Okay, example we are taking. Let what number one consumer. Consumer is consuming commodity X. First assumption, consumer is consuming commodity X. Okay. Number two, consumer has to spend rupees 10. Second क्या है, consumer को 10 रुपया खर्च करना है. Okay, consumer has to spend rupees 10. Okay, now number three is price of commodity X is rupees 2 per unit. Price of commodity X is rupees 2 per unit. Okay, now utility schedule of commodity X is given. Okay, utility schedule of commodity X is given. This is mu schedule of X. Mu schedule of X. Okay, so units of X, and here mux. Mux 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can take as many. Okay. 7. Again, I said simplified example. Example should be simple. Okay. So 7 units. From first unit, consumer is getting mu 10. From second, 8. Sorry, 8. From third, 6. From fourth, 4. From fifth, this is 2, from 6, 0, and from 7, minus 2. Okay, what we see that we know the nature of marginal utility. We have discussed law of diminishing marginal utility, that as more and more units of a commodity is consumed, utility derived from successive additional unit of the commodity keep declining. We have already explained. So, from the first unit of X, consumer is getting utility equal to 10, from second it is 8, from third it is 6, from fourth it is 4, from fifth it is 2, from sixth it is 0, from seventh it is minus 2. Okay, this is the marginal utility schedule of commodity X. As more and more units of commodity X consumer consumes, what happens? Consumer is getting less and less utility from successive additional unit of the commodity. Now here you see, at 0.6, consumer is getting zero utility. At 0.6, consumer is getting zero utility. Do you remember? In the previous lecture, I had told that if consumer reach at this point, well, this is known as point of satiety. Point of satiety. Now listen one thing here. What I say, when consumer reaches at point zero, that additional unit is not giving him any additional utility. Additional unit of commodity X is not giving any additional utility to consumer. So this is the point of satiety. Okay, means यहाँ पे consumer पूर्ण संतुष्ट है. कंज्यूम करके देखो अब यहाँ 6 यूनिट कंज्यूम कर रहा है 6 पे संतुष्ट है तो हम बोल सकते हैं कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम में 6 यूनिट कंज्यूम करके लेकिन ये बात नहीं है मेरे पास क्या है मेरे कंज्यूमर के पास खर्च करने के लिए 10 रुपया ही तो अब मुझे गाड़ी लेनी है संतुष्ट आप रहेंगे बोलेंगे मर्सिडीज मिल जाएगा रॉयल स्ट्राइस मिल जाएगा संतुष्ट रहेंगे आपके जनरेशन यंग जनरेशन बोलेगा लैम्बोर्गिनी मिल जाए मैं संतुष्ट रहूंगा सुपर बाइक मुझे हायाबुसा मिल जाए मैं संतुष्ट रहूंगा लेकिन संतुष्टि कभी बोलता है नहीं ये काल्पनिक बातें मत करो फर्स्ट यू डिजर्व देन डिजायर तो मेरे पास डिजर्व क्या है 10 रुपया है मेरे पास ओके अब 10 रुपया को मैं खर्च करूंगा यहाँ पे 10 रुपए खर्च कर रहा हूं तो मैं कितना यूनिट कंज्यूम कर रहा हूं तो मैं अगर 10 रुपया खर्च करता हूं यहां पे तो 5 यूनिट मुझे कंज्यूम कर सकता हूं आई विल बी एबल टू कंज्यूम 5 यूनिट्स आई विल बी एबल टू कंज्यूम 5 यूनिट्स सो आई कैन से हियर दैट गिवन द इनकम ऑफ कंज्यूमर दिया हुआ है गिवेन द इनकम ऑफ कंज्यूमर प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी एंड एमयू शेड्यूल ऑफ MU schedule of commodity X given the income of consumer, price of the commodity and MU schedule of commodity X. ये दिया हुआ है given, comma consumer will remain in equilibrium. Consumer will remain in equilibrium when he consumes what? 5 units of 5 units of commodity X. When he consumes 5 units of commodity X. Why? Why? Because at this level of consumption, condition of equilibrium is satisfied. Condition of equilibrium is satisfied. इसको लिखना होगा, पॉज करोगे लिखते जाओगे. Okay. Now, what is condition of equilibrium? तो आपने तो कह दिया कि condition of equilibrium is satisfied. तो ये भाई आपको प्रूफ देना पड़ेगा. तो पहला चीज कि कंडीशन ऑफ क्या है कंडीशन ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम है क्या क्या है यहां पे कमोडिटी x कंज्यूम कर रहा है कंज्यूमर तो mux by px should be equal to mul अब जो एग्जांपल मेरा है इन द गिवन एग्जांपल इन द गिवन एग्जांपल क्या है कंज्यूमर के पास 10 रुपया है 5 यूनिट कंज्यूम किया तो 5 यूनिट प्राइस कितना है पर यूनिट रुपीस 2 तो 5 यूनिट खरीदा 2 रुपया पर यूनिट खर्चा कितना हो गया 10 रुपया ओके एग्जांपल when consumer spends rupees 10 10 rupees jo kharcha kar raha hai when consumer spends rupees 10 kya hai consumer ko mux kitna mil raha hai consumer ko 2 rupees 2 rupees yahan kharch kiya प्लस 2 रुपया यहां खर्च किया 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 2 4 6 8 10 रुपया खर्चा उसका हो गया 10 रुपया उसका खर्च हो गया है ना 10 रुपया खर्च हो गया उसका तो MUX कितना इसका है MUX इज 2 यूटिलिटीज बिकॉज़ यूनिट ऑफ मेजरमेंट ऑफ यूटिलिटी इज यूटिलिटीज सो MUX इज 2 यूटिलिटीज ओके MUX is 2 utils. Number 2, PX is what? PX is what? PX is rupees 2 per unit. PX price of commodity is what? Price of commodity what we have taken? Rupees 2. Okay, so what? PX is 2. Got it? Okay, so when you put the value, when you put the value, then what will happen? 2 divided by 2. It should be equal to MUM. So another assumption we have to take one here. जिस तरह से एडिशनल यूनिट का यूटिलिटी हमको मिलता है मैंने एक्सप्लेन किया कमोडिटी में. So another assumption. I hope while discussing going through this question may have arisen in your mind. That's why I left this. Why I left this? I left that while discussing a question should come in your mind. कि सर ने तो कहा कि MUX by PX equal to MUM. Okay. और यहाँ पे लिख दिया कि commodity X consume कर रहा है 10 रुपया उसकी उसका खर्चा करना है उसे consumer को 2 रुपया कीमत है. MUM तो कुछ लिखा ही नहीं. इसलिए एग्जांपल जब भी लो एकदम बिल्कुल सिंपलीफाइड लो मैं क्या मान रहा हूं कि MUM ऑफ रुपीज 1 फॉर कंज्यूमर इज 1 ओके एजम्पशन 1 आप 4 ले लीजिएगा आप 10 ले सकते हैं नो प्रॉब्लम यू कैन टेक लेकिन फिर परेशानी क्या होगी आपको टेबल को उसी के हिसाब से और प्राइस को लेकर एडजस्ट करना पड़ेगा सो सिंपली टेक 1 इसके लिए नंबर नहीं कटने जा रहा है आपका सो We have assumed MUM is equal to 1. So 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So this condition of equilibrium is satisfied and consumer is in equilibrium. So this was the case of consumer's equilibrium in case of one commodity. Now as with the help of table we have explained, but in examination you need to explain with the help of diagram also. Okay, so simply no need, no problem. The thing is you have to draw a diagram on which you will put units of commodity X and you will put this MUX. So while discussing law of diminishing marginal utility, we have drawn the MU schedule. Similarly here also you have to draw. Okay, so we will take two axes with diagram. Time and again I say in examination you will not get graph paper. So your practice should be on ruled notebook. You know that plain paper you are not going to get in examination. Ruled notebook you should practice there only. So here we take units of x. I told you that independent variable taken on x-axis and dependent variable taken on y-axis. Mux depends on what? Mux depend on units of x. So units of x is independent here. So how many units? 7 units are there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay? And we know that we have minus in minus also. So this quadrant we have to minus y quadrant we have to go. Okay, I told you 4 quadrants are there and distance should be similar. Four, six, eight, ten. Okay? Here, minus 2. On the first unit, when consumer is consuming unit 1 of x, he is getting utility equal to 10. On second, his utility is equal to 8. First, put a dot. On third unit, utility is equal to 6. On fourth unit, utility is equal to 4. On second unit, utility on fifth unit, utility is equal to 2. On fifth unit, utility is equal to 2. On sixth unit, utility is equal to 0. And on seventh unit, utility is equal to minus 2. So we get a MUx curve. Okay, now listen one thing. It is not necessary that this utility will increase or decrease in a linear form. Not necessary at all. There is no rule like that. But for the sake of simplicity, we do this. It is not ki wo do hi doge sense mein girega, wo char char ke sense mein girega. Aisa koi rule nahi hai. I must tell you. Ye यहाँ से 10 से 8 हुआ ये हो सकता है कि 6 के बदला में 7 हो जाए फिर ये 7 के बदला में 5-6 हो जाए फिर ये 6 के बाद हो जाए 2 हो जाए ऐसा हो सकता है नॉन लीनियर फॉर्म में ये चेंज हो सकता है अब ये नहीं कि 10 के बाद 8 हो 8 के बाद 9 हो जाए इंक्रीज नहीं करेगा घटना है उसे घटना तो है ही घटना है बट किस रेट पे गिरेगा दैट इज नॉट फिक्स्ड But for the sake of convenience, to explain, it has become a convention to take like this. Okay, so what we see that on different units, we have taken the utility derived by consumer. Okay, now what we see? You see that consumer is in equilibrium when he is consuming 5 units of commodity X and MUx is 2. So we draw MUx is 2. You draw a line from here, what we see, this line touches here. We have drawn a line here from here and this line touches this point. Okay, so what we see, 5 units of x and mu is 2. So this is known as point of equilibrium. This is known as point of equilibrium, and this line is also known as line of equilibrium. This line is known as line of equilibrium, and the point where this mu becomes zero, is known as point of satiety. This point where mu becomes 0 is known as point of satiety. So this is consumer's equilibrium in case of single commodity cardinal approach with the help of schedule and with the help of diagram. Okay, now we will next move on to consumer's equilibrium in case of more than one commodity. This is very important, this is in case of more than one commodity. Now we will discuss consumer's equilibrium. Okay. So we will discuss this consumer's equilibrium cardinal approach in case of more than one commodity. More than one commodity. Look, the law through which Marshall explained this consumer's equilibrium in case of more than one commodity is known as law of equi-marginal utility. Law of equi-marginal utility. Why Marshall said like this? Marshall explained that if a consumer consumes different commodities, in case earlier case commodity X consumer are consuming. Now if consumer consumes different commodity, commodity X, commodity Y, commodity Z, मान लो समोसा भी खा रहे हो, रसगुल्ला भी खा रहे हो, इमरती भी खा रहे हो, तो उन्होंने कहा कि if consumer consumes different commodities, then consumer will remain in equilibrium. Consumer will remain in equilibrium when marginal utility derived from all the commodities become equal. क्या कि अगर वो मान लो रसगुल्ला भी खा रहा है, वो मान लो समोसा भी खा रहा है, वो इमरती भी खा रहा है, तो अगर मान लो रसगुल्ला से MU2 है, समोसा से MU2 है, इमरती से MU2 है, तो सबका क्या है, मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी इक्वल हो जाना. मतलब कमोडिटी एक्स कंज्यूमर इज कंज्यूमिंग, कमोडिटी वाई कंज्यूमर इज कंज्यूमिंग, कमोडिटी जेड कंज्यूमर इज कंज्यूमिंग, तो कंज्यूमर विल गेट मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू मार्शल. Consumer will get maximum satisfaction when marginal utility derived from all the commodities become equal. As he said that marginal utility derived from all the commodities should be equal, then only consumer will get maximum satisfaction and then only consumer will remain in equilibrium. Okay, that's why क्या बात की उन्होंने, equi-marginal utility, यानी हर एक commodity से मिलने वाला जो marginal utility है वो बराबर हो जाना चाहिए, इसीलिए उसे law of equi-marginal utility कहते हैं. चूंकि मार्शल के अनुसार अगर ऐसा कोई कंज्यूमर करेगा कि सब उसका सारा मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी बराबर हो जाए, उस केस में क्या होगा, उसको मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन मिलेगा. क्या मिलेगा, मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन. ओके, इसीलिए इसको लॉ ऑफ मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन ही बोलते हैं, लॉ ऑफ मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन ही बोलते हैं. ओके, अब इस चीज को अटेन करने के लिए कि जितने कमोडिटीज हम कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं, जितने कमोडिटीज हम कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं और सबसे मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी जो मुझे मिले वो इक्वल हो, इसके लिए कंज्यूमर को बहुत सारे परम्यूटेशन कॉम्बिनेशन करने पड़ेंगे. ये खाओ, नहीं ये नहीं, ये खाओ, अच्छा इस पैसा रसगुल्ला पे नहीं खर्च करो, गुलाब जामुन पे खर्च कर दो. अच्छा गुलाब जामुन हो गया, थोड़ा सा ज्यादा मिल गया है, अब एक काम करते हैं, गुलाब जामुन छोड़ के थोड़ा सा इमरती पे खर्च कर लेते हैं. कमोडिटी एक्स पे 4 रुपया खर्च किया है, ज्यादा मिल गया, हटा के थोड़ा 2 रुपया इधर खर्च कर दो, उधर ज्यादा हो गया, 3 रुपया इधर खर्च कर दो. क्या कर रहा है वो, सब्स्टिट्यूट कर रहा है. वो क्या कर रहा है, सब्स्टिट्यूट कर रहा है एक कमोडिटी को दूसरे कमोडिटी से, वो सब्स्टिट्यूट कर रहा है. क्योंकि वो एक कमोडिटी को दूसरे कमोडिटी से सब्स्टिट्यूट कर रहा है, इसीलिए इसको लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन ही बोला गया है. इसीलिए इसको लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन ही बोला गया है. एक्चुअली में जब आप जाएंगे हायर स्टेज में पढ़ने के लिए, ग्रेजुएशन में, पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन में, और वहां पे आपको ये पढ़ना होगा, ये लॉ ऑफ कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम इन केस ऑफ मोर देन वन कमोडिटी, तो वहां पे हो सकता है पूछ दे एक्सप्लेन लॉ ऑफ इक्वी मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी, हो सकता है पूछ दे लॉ ऑफ मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन, या पूछ दे व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन. और गॉसेन से हमने भी एक्सप्लेन किया था इसको, इसीलिए इसको बोला जाता है गॉसेंस सेकेंड लॉ, इसलिए इसको गॉसेंस सेकेंड लॉ भी बोला जाता है. ओके, सो दिस द लॉ थ्रू विच this consumer's equilibrium in case of more than one commodity is explained is known by different names. It is having different identity. That's why I have written, so that you may not confuse. Okay. So what this law says, earlier we said that in case consumer consumes many commodities, consumer will remain in equilibrium if marginal utility derived from consumption of different units of a commodity is equal. Okay, Marshall has explained it with in case of one commodity given equation MUX by PX equal to MUM. Same thing here also Marshall has given. Okay, let's see what Marshall say. Time and again I say you all, you see the examples here, don't by heart this example. What you do, you develop your own example. That should, pattern should be same. Okay, you develop your own example because the way things are changing, numericals will come. The way things are changing, many open book systems, suppose this corona persists, then open book system may be there. And in that case, if question is framed, question will be such that you cannot answer those questions by opening the book, no. By opening the notes of the teacher, no. You would be able to answer that question only when you have a complete understanding. So understanding based questions will be there. That's why time and again it is requested to you all. I request you all, I suggest you all, I advise you all that you go through the whole topic in totality, try to understand. After going through the lecture, you read the textbook. After reading the textbook, you again watch the lecture, prepare your notes, prepare your own example, and this way you can memorize these things, you can understand these things in totality. So what Marshall said, in case of more than one commodity, he said, suppose many commodities consumer consumes, like commodity one, suppose MUX consumer is consuming, so MUX by PX, suppose MUY consumer is consuming commodity Y, so MUY by PY, okay, should be equal to MU, suppose nth commodity by price of nth commodity. So Marshall says that if this condition is fulfilled, then consumer will be able to get maximum satisfaction. Okay. So suppose consumer is consuming commodity X, commodity Y, nth commodity Y, Z, WX, whatever. Okay. So this should be satisfied, then only consumer will be in equilibrium. For sake of simplicity, we take two commodity. More than one, we take two commodity. Now, we will explain with the help of example. Okay. We will explain with the help of example. Okay. We take two. Let consumer consumes two commodity. Number one. What? Consumer. Consumes X and Y. Consumer क्या consume कर रहा है? Commodity X and commodity Y. Consumer क्या consume कर रहा है? Commodity X और commodity Y. Okay. अब क्या है? Number two. Consumer has rupees 8 to spend. Consumer has rupees 8 to spend. Consumer ke paas 8 rupiya hai kharch karne ko. Theek hai? Number 3. PX has rupees 1 or PI has rupees 1. Yani ki PX aur PY dono 1 rupiya hai. PX rupees 1 or PY rupees 1. Okay. Is this clear or not? I hope it is clear to you all. Example, this what we have taken, that consumer consumes commodity X and commodity Y. Number two, consumer has rupees 8 to spend. Number three, price of commodity X is rupees 1, price of commodity Y is rupees 1. Okay, so now fourth assumption. क्या छोड़ दिया था मैंने पिछले बार आप लोगों के लिए कि मनी का मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी क्या है. ओके, मनी का मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी क्या है, हम लिए थे हम लोग ना, याद है कि नहीं है, बोलिए. ओके, शायद याद है आप लोगों को. मैं फिर छोड़ देंगे, अभी फिर छोड़ देंगे. क्यों? एक ट्रिक बताऊंगा कि उसे क्या लेना है. पहले से ले लोगे, हो सकता है कि बाद में कैलकुलेशन में परेशानी हो. तो वन थिंग आई विल टेल यू कि क्या लेना है, कैसे लेना है, उसको क्या ज्यूम करना है दिमाग में बाद में. ओके, नाउ आवर बेस इज रेडी. कंज्यूमर कंज्यूम्स कमोडिटी एक्स एंड वाई. कंज्यूमर हैज रुपीज 8 टू स्पेंड. प्राइस ऑफ कमोडिटी एक्स इज रुपीज 1 पर यूनिट. वाई प्राइस ऑफ वाई इज रुपीज 1 पर यूनिट. सो आवर बेस इज रेडी. नाउ व्हाट इज कंडीशन ऑफ कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम हियर. कंज्यूमर्स कंडीशन ऑफ कंज्यूमर्स इक्विलिब्रियम इज इफ कमोडिटी टू कमोडिटीज आर बीइंग कंज्यूम्ड बाय कंज्यूमर. Then consumer will remain in equilibrium if mu x by px is equal to mu y by py, which is equal to mu m. Okay, mu x equal to divided by px equal to mu y divided by py equal to mu m. Mu x means marginal utility derived from consumption of commodity x. Px price of commodity x. Mu y marginal utility derived from consumption of commodity y. Py is the price of y. And mu m is marginal utility of money for consumer, which we have not assumed. We have left this column blank. Okay. Now, if this condition is satisfied, then consumer remains in equilibrium. Okay, so let's take a schedule based on given the schedule of these two commodities, commodity X and commodity Y, see how consumer spends. Now, we take here units 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Don't go for many units. Okay, here you take MUX, here you take MUY. Ab dekho, फर्स्ट यूनिट जब ये कंज्यूमर एक्स का फर्स्ट यूनिट कंज्यूम कर रहा है तो उसको मिल रहा है 10, फिर 9, फिर 8, फिर 7, फिर 6, फिर 5. ओके, क्या देख रहे हैं? देखो ये जरूरी नहीं क्या ये घटते हुए क्रम में होना चाहिए. दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट, ये घटते हुए क्रम में होना चाहिए. ओके, और जब ये कमोडिटी वाई कंज्यूम कर रहा है तो उसको मिल रहा है फर्स्ट यूनिट से 8, सेकेंड से 7, थर्ड से 6, फिर 5, फिर 4, फिर 3. ये तो बहुत नेचुरल है. ये कंज्यूमर जो है थोड़ा एक्स को ज्यादा लाइक करता है इन कंपेरिजन टू वाई. ये क्योंकि उसको क्या हो रहा है कि जब वो एक्स कंज्यूम कर रहा है तो फर्स्ट यूनिट में 10 मिल रहा है, यहाँ 18 मिल रहा है. अब देखो कंज्यूमर के पास कितना है, 8 रुपया खर्च करने को है. अब हम थोड़ा सा बताने की कोशिश मैं कर रहा हूँ कि वो जो लोग पढ़े लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन तो वो कैसे खर्च करेगा. देखो अब वो पहला रुपया कहाँ खर्च करेगा, यहाँ या यहाँ. अगर यहाँ करता है तो 10 मिलता है उसे, यहाँ खर्च करता है तो 1 मिलता है. खर्च करेगा कहाँ, यहाँ करेगा, यहाँ नहीं करेगा, क्योंकि इकोनॉमिक्स का बेसिक एजम्पशन है कंज्यूमर इज रैशनल. सो फर्स्ट रुपीज अपना वो यहाँ खर्च किया. ओके, सेकेंड यूनिट अगर यहाँ खर्च करता है तो 9 मिल रहा है उसे, यहाँ खर्च कर रहा है तो 8 मिल रहा है उसे. तो सेकेंड यूनिट कहाँ खर्च करेगा, 9 पे खर्च कर देगा. थर्ड यूनिट यहाँ भी 8 मिल रहा है, यहाँ भी 8 मिल रहा है. अब मान लो कि हम जाएंगे रसगुल्ला और समोसा खाने के लिए, सिर्फ रसगुल्ला ही नहीं खाएंगे, कुछ नमकीन भी चाहिए। ये ऑलरेडी चूंकि यहाँ भी 8 मिलेगा और यहाँ भी 8 मिलेगा, तो वो दोनों के यूटिलिटी के टर्म में वो दोनों में इंडिफरेंट रहेगा। कंज्यूमर विल रिमेन इंडिफरेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ यूटिलिटी, बट एज कंज्यूमर इज ऑलरेडी हैविंग 2 यूनिट्स ऑफ एक्स, सो आई विल प्रेफर टू हैव 1 यूनिट ऑफ वाई, तो 3rd रुपीज वो यहाँ खर्च कर देगा। ओके, अब 4th रुपीज जब खर्च करने की बारी आई तो क्या करेगा वो, यहाँ खर्च करेगा तो 7 मिलेगा, यहाँ खर्च करेगा तो 8 मिलेगा, नेचुरली ये 4th यूनिट ये यहाँ खर्च करेगा। ओके, 5th यूनिट यहाँ भी 7, यहाँ भी 7, देखो लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन की बात बोल रहे हैं, सब्स्टिट्यूट कर रहे हैं यहाँ से वहां कर रहे हैं सब्स्टिट्यूट हम लोग, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज लॉ ऑफ सब्स्टिट्यूशन। तो 5th यूनिट कहाँ खर्च करेगा, यहाँ भी 7, यहाँ भी 7, ये 3 ऑलरेडी है, ये एक ही ऑलरेडी है, बेसिक ह्यूमन टेंडेंसी जो कम होता है हम लेने की कोशिश करते हैं, तो 5th यूनिट ये यहाँ खर्च कर देगा। 6th अगर यहाँ खर्च करेगा तो 6 मिल रहा है, यहाँ खर्च कर रहा है तो 7 मिल रहा है, तो 6th यूनिट ये यहाँ खर्च कर देगा। 7th यहाँ भी खर्च करेगा 6, यहाँ भी खर्च करेगा 6, तो ये ऑलरेडी 4 उसके पास है, ये 2 ही है, तो 7th यूनिट ये यहाँ खर्च करेगा। 8th यूनिट यहाँ खर्च किया तो 5, यहाँ खर्च किया तो 6, इसलिए वो क्या करेगा तो यहाँ पे 8th यूनिट खर्च कर देगा। अब देखो जो ये जो बांटा है पैसे को इस तरीके से बांटा, वो यूटिलिटी कितना उसको मिल रहा है, ये 10 प्लस 9 प्लस 8 प्लस 7 प्लस 6, ओके वो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 यूनिट किसका कंज्यूम किया, एक्स का, 5 यूनिट को कंज्यूम किया एक्स का। व्हेन इट कंज्यूमिंग 5 यूनिट्स ऑफ एक्स, तो टोटल यूटिलिटी दिस इज एमयू 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 टीयू एक्स, हाउ मच हाउ मच टीयू एक्स इज गिविंग, क्या हम बोलते हैं सम टोटल ऑफ एमयू इज इक्वल टू टीयू। तो देखो आज मौका मिल गया हम लोगों को, 10 प्लस 9 हाउ मच 19, प्लस 8 हाउ मच 27, प्लस 7 हाउ मच 10 प्लस 9 19 प्लस 8 कितना 27, प्लस 7 हाउ मच 34, प्लस 6 हाउ मच कितना हो गया 40। ओके और अब देखो उसको y से कितना मिल रहा है, y से कितना मिला उसको 8 प्लस 7 प्लस 6, ओके तो tu y कितना मिल गया उसको 8 प्लस 7 15 प्लस 6 कितना हो गया 21, तो tu उसको कितना टोटल मिल गया, tu उसको कितना मिल गया मतलब tu x प्लस TUY, TUX कितना है 40 प्लस TUY 21 कितना हो गया 61, इस टोटल TU इज 61। अब तुम देखो ये जो कॉम्बिनेशन दिया हुआ है, इस कॉम्बिनेशन के अलावा कोई भी कॉम्बिनेशन, एनी अदर कॉम्बिनेशन अदर देन दिस कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ X एंड Y विल गिव कंज्यूमर TU लेस देन 61, because by substituting his expense he is able to maximize his utility, that's why this law is known as law of maximum satisfaction, because he has substituted each other, that is this law is known as law of substitution, because here when he consumes 5 units of x and 3 units of y, what we see that mu is equal, mu is equal, that's why this is known as law of equi-marginal utility। अब देखो मान लो कि वो सारा पैसा x पे खर्च कर देता, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 यूनिट हुआ, अगर मान लो इसको हम थोड़ा आगे बढ़ा दें, फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये 7वां यूनिट, ये 8वां यूनिट, इससे 5 मिला, 4 मिलता, मान लो 3 मिलता, कितना होता है 10, 9, 9, 7 27 प्लस 7 34 प्लस 6 40 प्लस 5 45 प्लस 4 49 प्लस 3 52 TU 61 से कम था, सारा पैसा यहां खर्च कर देता अगर सारा पैसा यहां तो मान लो इसको 2 मिलता इसको 1 मिलता यहां पे तो 8 plus 7 15 plus 6 21 plus 5 26 plus 4 30 plus 3 33 plus 2 35 plus 1 36 तो देखो ये दोनों ही केस में पर सारा पैसा वाई पे खर्च कर देता तो 36 सारा पैसा एक्स पे खर्च करता तो 52 तो इसने पैसे को इस तरह से खर्च किया दोनों पे मिला करके कि उसको मैक्सिमम सेटिस्फैक्शन मिला और पैसा कैसे खर्च किया 5 एक्स पे और 3 वाई का सो दैट क्या हुआ कि दोनों का जो मार्जिनल इक्वलिटी है वो भी इक्वल हो गया Okay, so when consumer consumes more than one commodity, he consumer gets maximum satisfaction when utility derived from consumption of different commodities, MU derived from consumption of different commodities become equal. Okay, so what we see here, our condition of equilibrium is what? MUX by PX equal to MUY by PY equal to MUM. Now, come here. अब क्या देखना है देखो क्योंकि एग्जांपल हमें उसे प्रूव करना है तो MUX का कितना है जब वो 6 यूनिट कंज्यूम 5 यूनिट x का कंज्यूम कर रहा है तो व्हेन कंज्यूमर कंज्यूमिंग 5 यूनिट्स ऑफ x MUX इज 6 PX इज हाउ मच 1 6 बाय 1 इक्वल टू MU y when consumer consumes 3 units of x y sorry 3 units of y so when consumer is consuming 3 units of y so what is MU y 6 MU y is 6 and price of y is rupees 1 so 6 by 1 divided by 6 by 1 will be 6 equal to 6 और क्या बोल रहा है इट शुड बी इक्वल टू एमयू 1 ये क्या होना चाहिए इसको भी 6 होना चाहिए तो पहले से नहीं डाले हम एग्जांपल अब यहां लेते हैं कि एमयू इज 6 अज्यूम करना है हमें ले लिया ये मेरा एग्जांपल हो गया अजम्पशंस हो गया बेस्ड ऑन दिस व्हेन कंज्यूमर नाउ इन केस ऑफ मोर देन वन कमोडिटी इफ कंज्यूमर इज कंज्यूमिंग x एंड y एंड ही इज कंज्यूमिंग 5 यूनिट्स ऑफ x and 3 units of y, of course, his income, his price of commodity and MUM is given, then consumer remains in equilibrium when he is consuming 5 units of x and 3 units of y. Because at this level of consumption, this condition of equilibrium is satisfied. Now, you have to explain this with the help of diagram also. There are two types of diagram. The two different diagrams are there through which you can explain it. We will learn here both diagrams. Okay, both the diagrams we will be learning here. So for the space, I'm moving it. This all I have erased, and this table also we will shift. We will shift this table here. This table will be our reference. Without reference, we cannot draw a diagram. So units 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now MUX 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. MUY 8. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. So we have shifted our table at this place. Okay. Now this table is our reference and we will draw diagram here. Okay. Both diagrams are very simple. First diagram, what we did in the previous, same we will do. See here. Units again, we know that units will take here. 6 units are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and PU, when you take here, two, four, six, eight, 10 here. Okay. Now this is on y-axis. On y-axis we have taken mux and muy. On y-axis we have taken mux and muy pair units. So first we draw mux curve. Okay. Mux on first unit mux is 10. On second it is 9. On second it is 9, on third it is 8, on third it is 8, okay, on fourth it is 7, on fifth it is 6, on sixth it is, okay. I am drawing diagrams like because you understand the process. Because otherwise, if I draw the diagram already and explain, you won't be able to understand the process to how to draw diagrams. That's why I do this. Okay. So this is our MUX. Now MUY. On first it is 8. On second it is 7, on third it is 6, on fourth it is 5, on fifth it is 4, on sixth it is 3. So this is our MUY curve. Okay, now see equilibrium. What we have seen that when consumer consumes 5 units of X and 3 units of Y, then he will remain in equilibrium. When consumer consumes 5 units of X and 3 units of Y, then consumer remains in equilibrium. Okay, so 5 units of X and 3 units of Y. When consumer is consuming, then consumer is in equilibrium. And mu is what? Mu is 6 from both. So what you do, you take a line from here, draw a line. This line is known as line of equilibrium. Line of equilibrium. What is mu6 here? mu6 here. You draw a line from here on x-axis. What you get? 3. Muy. Muy. 3 units of muy is being consumed. You draw from here. 5. Means 5 units of muy is consumed. Okay. So what we see? What we see that mux is equal to MUY. Okay, so consumer is in equilibrium. This is one type of diagram. Same diagram, same thing we can plot through other diagram also. Okay, see how. Same thing, okay. Here 2 mux and muy. So on this x-axis, we will be taking units. Okay, now unit is how much unit? How much unit units are there? 6 units are there. How much units are there? 6 units are there. So 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and mu is 10. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So on this side, we are taking what? We are taking mux. On this side, we are taking mux. Okay, and this side, we are taking MUY. This side we are taking MUY. So it clear to all? It clear? So you see, this is from 1 to 5 and 6. This is units of x from this side to this side. Okay, from this side to this side, from this side to this side, these are the units of y. Okay. Okay, from this side, units from this side, this side, we will take units of y. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So from this side to this side, units of y. I hope it is clear to you all. And again, here we will same. This should be at the same with the scaling measure. At the same the scaling should be there. Okay, for both the commodities. Four, six, eight. Now, MUY there, MUX this side. Now, you draw MUX curve. MUX curve, on the first range, it is 10, first 10, second 9, second it is 9, third it is 8, third it is 8, fourth it is 7, so fourth it is 7, fifth it is 6, fifth it is 6, sixth it is 5, sixth it is 5. So we got MUX curve. We got MUX curve. Okay, no problem. Now MUY. While drawing MUX curve, what we did? While drawing MUX curve, what we did? We considered this. Now we will draw MUY curve. MUY curve we will be drawing. Now see, on the first bit, MUY is how much? On the first bit, MUY is 8. On the first, MUY is MUY is 8. On second, MUY is 7. On second, MUY is 7. This is for MUY. It was for MUX. This is first unit of MU, first unit of Y, second unit of Y, third unit of Y. Okay, from this side we are moving for X. From this side, we are moving for X. White 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is of X, number of X. And this yellow 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is the units of Y. Okay, so keep in mind. Okay, so from second what we got? 7. From third what we are getting? 6. From third unit we are getting 6. From fourth we are getting 5. From fourth we are getting 5. And from fifth we are getting 4. From fifth we are getting 4, and from sixth we are getting 3. So we draw this mu y curve. So point of intersection is here. Point of intersection is between mu x and mu y is at point E. And from here, if you draw a line, what you see? 5 units of x is consumed and 3 units of y is consumed. Then consumer is in equilibrium. 5 units of x, mu is 6, 3 units of y, mu is 6. Mu of both is equal. Okay. So this is our here what we say, point of consumers equilibrium. Okay, here mux by px is equal to muy by dy equal to mum. Okay, this is our consumers equilibrium in more than one commodity. I hope it is clear to you all. Next lecture, we will move on to consumers equilibrium ordinal approach, that is known as indifference curve approach. Yeah, that is very important. So when I make the next video, it will be notified to you, and the video will be notified to you only when you subscribe this channel, you like the video and you share it. Thank you.